Hello everyone, this is Pawfect, and welcome back to my Stardew Valley Let's Play series. Getting through winter now. Cannot wait to the end of it, to be honest. I feel like winter's really slow. There's not as much to do. Spend some time with the parrot today. It breaks my heart that he'll never fly again. Makes a very strange noise. Poor little parrot. So what do we got? Beautiful sunny day tomorrow, and beautiful sunny day all day tomorrow. And spirits are in good humour. Very good. And it's snowing, so that's a thing as well. Now, we are going to hand these in to Gunther today. What else we got? Need another iron bar. Okay, we can do that. Let's grab an iron bar for Clint. So, today. So we need to make a spot in our, in our greenhouse for our ancient seed that we'll eventually get. Let's grab all of these. And we'll grab, it looks like all our, well not all, but some of our oak resins done as well. How's this going? Oh, they're still a while away. Let's keep grabbing all these. A couple more here. We might actually make some more barrels today as well, because we've got some spare star fruit. And we can probably even chuck kegs in the barn, or even this coop or something like that, because there's plenty of space left over in those. Let's not get too slowed by these guys. They don't hit for very much, so I'm not too worried about dying by them. But it's more just the slow. They're just annoying when they slow you. But we are going to keep grabbing the slime. Yep. So let's do the animals next, and then we'll head over to Gunther and to hand in our artifacts. Get all the cheese. Yep. Nope, no milk today. I feel like our pigs are kind of useless in in winter, they don't really do a whole lot. But hopefully that'll pick up come spring. Let's keep talking about pigs. Talking about goats. So, how much milk did we end up getting? We got plenty. And a couple of iridium style goat milk. Let's put those away. We'll put those away later. Okay, so the question is, do we go to the secret forest? We should probably actually do our chickens first. I have forgotten these before. Okay, so while we're doing this, and we've got a feather, which is always cool, I'm probably going to do some streaming over this New Year's weekend. So it's going to be quite irregular. I don't really have any specific times. Just when I feel like streaming, I'll be streaming. So if anyone's interested in coming along and watching me stream, by all means, I'll just be playing my stream account, which is, where is it up to? I think it's up to day 7, nothing too far through the game. And I'll just be playing through and answering any questions. If you want to come along and ask me any questions, or just come along and have a chat, that'll be great. Once this episode is out, I'll probably be streaming relatively soon after it's been released. So maybe try and catch me. So I'll be streaming on Twitch TV under the handle Pawfect89, if you're interested. If not, that's fine. I'll just go along and play some fun games by myself. I also want to try to do a top 10 list over the weekend. I'm not quite sure how it'll go. I'm going to try my best to get it done. We'll just have to see. It'll probably need me to do a little bit more editing, because I don't really do a whole lot of editing in these videos. I just sort of record do a few checks and then just save them and upload them. But I'm planning to do a few different scenes, go through some things. We'll see how it goes. Hopefully I can get that done this weekend. I want to do a top 10 tips, but more advanced tips. I've been watching some YouTube videos of some other people that have been doing top 10, and there's a lot of videos out there on very basic tips. Things like set up this setting, which you probably notice I don't use. Always hire a tooltip. Don't buy the coop too early. Go to bed on time. All those sort of basic beginner things. I want to try doing a few more advanced tips. I won't spoil any of those tips at this stage, but knowing the style I place, there's some tips you can probably guess that I'll bring to the table. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. I'm kind of looking forward to it. Anyway, back to the game today. Actually, before we go over to Clint and Gunther, let's have a quick look down here. I should probably have brought some geodes, actually, but I forgot to do that. Which is fine. I'm wondering whether or not we don't sell these coral today, because we need coral for... Did we just get two? We did. Okay, interesting. We need two coral... You know, we don't need that either. We don't need that. We need five coral, I think, maybe 10, for one of the obelisks. So we'll keep a stockpile of that. I'm not going to get those anytime soon, though. So let's hand these in. And give the iron bar to Clint. And then we'll head back to our farm. I feel like winter is quite slow. It just feels like I haven't really been doing too much in all of winter. What do I need? I don't need anything. I need you to stay away from Emily because you keep wanting me to give her amethysts from you. We are married, Clint. Donate to the museum. So what have we got? So there's that and that one. New reward. So now we should be able to get... Yep, the ancient seed. There we go. So I'm quite pleased we've got that. So where's our... And we've got broken glasses, which we don't really need. So where's our pony? There you are. So let's head back to the farm now and plant this ancient seed. And we'll probably put it in the greenhouse. An acorn. I don't really care about an acorn. I don't really care about that either. So let's just head back to the farm. I looked up the other day on the wiki about foraging skill, because I feel like we've been on level 9 for so long, and it is something that is sort of known to take a long time, but I think collecting all these forage items around the place give you 7 skill points towards foraging, whereas if you collect them on your farm, they only give you 3. So the ones you make from wild seeds only give you 3, all these winter seeds only give you 3. Whereas finding them around the place give you 7. Also, chopping down each hardwood stump, I think, gives you 25. And for those that are interested, you need a grand total of, I think, 5,000 skill points to get from level 9 to level 10. So we've chopped down a lot of hardwood, so hopefully we're not too far away with that. I think I accidentally sold some coral, didn't I? Oh well, I'll be the stupid person that does that. Let's put those away. We're back up to 21 oak resin. What else don't we need? I think that's probably up to 27 iridium bars. That's going really well. I think we might do some fishing again today, because I want to get that level up as well. And I'm thinking we won't need too much. So I'm just going to make that normal quality, because I'm probably going to spend most of my time with ancient seeds, using them to to get more seeds back in the seed maker. So it doesn't really matter what quality they are, because you get the same amount of seeds back. Could probably plant a coffee bean in there as well. But we won't do that. I don't think we're gonna have enough time, actually. What do we need to make these spinners? Or do we want to make some magnets? Maybe we'll try fishing with magnets, because we'll see if we can get some more treasure chests. Now, I feel like there's something else you can get. Treasure. Fish don't escape while collecting treasure, also slightly increases the chance. So that's tackle, and that's bait. So maybe... Oh, that's each individual one. So one bar. Jeez, that doesn't seem worth it, actually. Maybe we'll keep the bait, but maybe we'll make some treasure hunters. So let's maybe make three of those. There we go. But we'll just use normal bait, because I think that'll also help getting... actually, let's just grab half, and let's make all this into bait. Yep, and let's do some fishing, and hopefully we can get some treasure chests. So I think where I'm going to go fishing today will be up near the mine. I think that's the best space for us to go today, and I nearly accidentally went to the desert again. So let's go down here. So hopefully we can get some chests along the way, and maybe we can get really lucky and get ourselves a dinosaur egg, because you can get those from fishing. That's where I've got one on one of my previous playthroughs. So hopefully we can get some of those while fishing. Fish don't escape while collecting treasures, also slightly increases the chance to find treasures. Treasure chests. So come on, find ourselves some treasure chests. I wonder with the magnets if you get it every single time, though. If you did get it every single time, maybe it's worth it. We should probably have tested that. That's okay. I would normally skip through fishing, but this won't be a very long fishing session, so I'm just going to play through it. And every now and then, fishing isn't too bad. Bullhead. So what are we up to? Up to the 17th of winter now. So what do we want to try to get done by the end of winter? Well, I think we're going to try to do our best going through with Mr. Key, although I remembered the other day, which is partly the reason why I haven't progressed with going to Mr. Key. Chi? It might be Chi or Key. The one so you go gambling in the desert behind Sandy's shop. You need to have a rainbow shell, and I don't think I've got one of those, and I don't think you can get them until summer. So I won't be able to progress through that quest chain without a rainbow shell, so it's something I probably should have kept. But I haven't done that. Tell you what, this fish is getting tricky to catch, or maybe I'm just getting worse at catching them. I think it's probably a combination of both. I wonder what this fish is, actually, because this is being quite tricky to catch. Is it a sturgeon, maybe? I didn't think sturgeon were this difficult. It's a lingcod. Well, I didn't think they were that hard either, but anyway. That took a fair bit of time. So I'll try to start the Mr. Key quest chain, or Chi, but I'm just not convinced we'll be able to finish it. We'll see how far we can get. I should probably check what other things we need. What do we get? Come on, that's a terrible, terrible chest. We need chests with artifacts. I should probably check what other items we need for that quest chain, just so I don't accidentally sell something that, you know, only appears in winter, and then all of a sudden we'll be in spring or summer, and we won't have that item. $5.30 now. Getting a few largemouth bass. So is there anything else? What else have I got going on these days? So I'm obviously feeling a fair bit better since I was six. Apologies for taking that big, long break. I did feel like I needed a break as well. But I'm back now, and I want to keep pumping out some episodes. I want to try to make a few non-sort of series episodes. Things like, you know, what seeds should you plant in spring, and what seeds should you plant in summer for various circumstances, and doing a bit of review of things like that. Let me know in the comments if you're interested in seeing episodes like that. If you're not, well, I might have a go at doing them anyway, but I want to try to do things that people will be interested in if I can. Let's get this chest down here. And the fish, I tell you what, it does make it easier when you don't drop the fishing bar when you're collecting treasure chests. And an Nautilus shell, we have got one of those before. So that's the artifact version. There's the ones you can just find on the beach, and then there's an artifact version that you can donate to Gulliver. That's the artifact version. And I think once we've done or maxed our fishing level, I probably won't really do any more fishing in this series at all, because I probably mentioned it before, I don't think fishing gives you enough gold for the time that it takes. I think if you want gold and you don't want to do farming, you're probably better off doing mining, although that being said, I typically spend a lot of money on bombs while I'm mining, but you could probably still earn more gold mining even if you didn't use bombs. I might have to test that actually one day. Maybe we'll do a test where we'll do a few days of fishing and a few days of mining and compare the average gold that we earned on both. And be curious to see what comes back. Because I've always felt that mining in the low levels of the mine, so even just, you know, the normal mine from level, say, 100 to 120 will give you more money that per day than fishing will. But I've never really tested that. I've just sort of felt that to be true. And I've never really sold ore or bars. So I think if you, you know, grab all the gems, sell all the gems, but then also sell the ore and the bars, it probably makes it even more beneficial mining. But once again, I've never fully tested that properly, and maybe it's worth doing at some stage. And what have we got in this chest? We're not really getting very good items from these chests. What have we got? We've got a fair bit of, not a fair bit, we've got a little bit of, I don't know what you call it, durability left on the bobber, the treasure hunter. Ooh, you were way too quick and I was not prepared for that. Some of them I think are very difficult, possibly even impossible to get sometimes. That one may not have been, if I reacted a bit quicker I might have been able to get that, but I wasn't quick enough. I generally think I'm not too bad at fishing. I know a lot of people don't seem to like fishing at all, and some people I'm sure absolutely love fishing. I'm sort of, I do fishing sort of out of necessity. Alright, what do we got? So we've had both of those before. Tell you what, is that three or four drying starfish we've got today? That's pretty crazy. I wanted to get artifacts, I just want to get the same ones over and over again. Wish we could trade them in for new artifacts. 8, 10 now. How much bobber we've got? Maybe we'll fish until we finish this bobber. And then we'll head back to the farm. And we should just get just a little bit of gold from all this fishing tackle. Okay, so this will be the last one. We've got plenty of bait. Bait's not, doesn't seem to be an issue for us. Oh, look at that. Just as the patch there just started. But we're not going to bother with fishing, although we could do that. But it'll just be a fair bit more time. Time that I don't really want to spend fishing. Okay, so let's head back to the farm now. And we might even make some more kegs. Maybe we can have a look at doing that. We need a fair bit more wood for kegs, I think. Before we do that, let's just put that back in there. And sell these. Yeah, I'm just going to put that in there. And do we want to make some more kegs? You know what? Yes, we will. So what do we need? We need, I think they're the recipe. Is that the recipe? Yep. So what are we going to be short of? We're going to be short on iron bars, possibly short on wood. Actually, we will be short on wood. Wood will be the limiting factor there. So we might have to buy some more wood from Robin. Where do we want to put our kegs? Yep, so we do have some coral there. Let's put our iron bars away. Do we want to just put them on the side? Or, actually, we could even put our kegs in with our casks, actually. Temporarily, then we might put some... Actually, can we put them here? Can we put them in our house? We can. Okay, well, maybe we'll fill our house up with kegs. Yep, we can do that. I know a lot of people furnish their house. I'm going to make it more functional. We're going to be full of kegs. And kegs are going to be everywhere. We'll have the keg house. Now, while we've made those, we might as well actually grab some starfruit and chuck some starfruit in those. So, let's just grab all of it. And we'll make some starfruit wine. Nope, we don't want to eat that. Can I not reach that one? Maybe I can reach from this side. There we go. Okay, so we've got a few more kegs going along now. And we'll put that away. So we've got another 10 oak resin. I'm thinking that we might just have an early day today. At some stage we'll probably set our house out a little bit better, because it is a little bit average, but I think we'll probably have a shorter day today. Swap the whole house, wash the windows, dust it, and clean the fridge. It was a very productive day. Well done. Do I have anything to give you? Not really. So let's just have an early night and we'll go to bed. So no fishing levels, no forage levels, but hopefully just that little bit ticked it along okay. We've got another decent amount of gold, another 7,000. Not too bad at all. And our total gold is up to how much now? Let's have a quick look. I don't know why, I like to stand here when I end an episode. Our total gold is 1.37 mil, so not too bad at all. Anyway, thank you all for watching this episode. I do hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to like if you did. And besides that, I will see you all in the next episode. Thanks, guys. See you later. Bye.